Welcome to the HMG Executive Leadership Spotlight, where we showcase the best of the best global business technology executives inspiring trust and winning in a global digital economy. And now here's our host, Hunter Muller, founder and CEO of HMG Strategy.
Hello, and welcome to the HMG Spotlight. I'm excited and delighted to be here with you today. And we have our good friend, Eric Yuan, founder and CEO of Zoom. I'm so excited, Eric, to have you on today's program. Great to see you.
Thank you, Hunter. Thank you so much for the invitation.
Hey, you have an amazing career, an amazing journey, an amazing story of immigrating from China to the States and working at WebEx with John Chambers and then coming up with a big idea to change the world and make the world a better place in terms of a digital platform. Now, Zoom's an iconic brand. And in 2020, before the pandemic, you were cited as Time Businessman of the Year. What an amazing piece of recognition. Eric, what did it mean to you? And what was your passion and your why? How did you come about the whole vision for Zoom? And you've been on a long road. What have you learned?
Yeah, thank you, Hunter. I think, first of all, I'm so grateful to the community to support. And as you mentioned, I moved to Silicon Valley since 1997. I was so grateful to the community to support. I learned learned from so many great leaders. And I knew actually someday I might start my own company because I call Silicon Valley Startup Valley. I was working on WebEx technology for many, many years. And back to 2010, and I realized the world does need to have a new solution. And we got to build something from, to start over, to build a new solution with a video as a foundation. And of course, back then, most of the solutions were not built for video collaboration, right? And the experience is not great. I look at everything from a customer perspective, what I can do differently to build a new solution to truly deliver happiness back to those customers. That's the reason why I left to start my own company. My vision was very simple. I thought somebody in the future, a video conferencing like a Zoom, can deliver a better experience than face-to-face in-person meeting. And we are not there yet, but that's a vision. And we are still, I would say, in the middle of the process to transform Zoom to become a platform company to truly deliver happiness to every user.
You know, thank you. That sounds music to our ears here. You know, you really did keep the world connected in probably the worst event in 100 years, economic and health event. You know, you do some amazing work, and I know you have an amazing engineering team. And how do you keep them inspired, your company inspired? And we both share the love for the work Stephen M.R. Covey does. How do you keep your people engaged, happy, and healthy?
Yeah, that's a great question. I still remember on day one, after I started Zoom, right? I did two things. One thing is to buy, used furniture, right? I got to assemble the furniture. Another thing to write down was to write down our company, the culture and value. I think when it comes to company culture, it is extremely important, right? What kind of employee you want to hire, right? And what kind of a culture you want to promote. In our case, our company culture, just the two words, deliver happiness. Meaning for me, as the CEO of the company, my number one priority is to make sure our employee happy. Together as a business, we make our customer happy. So that's our company culture. But again, it's not that easy now because we have several thousand employees, how to maintain that culture. I think number one thing is really make sure, we build a very trustable environment where we all trust each other. Right? That's why, speed of trust, Stephen Covey's book is our favorite book, right? If the trust exists, sometimes you hire new employees and they understand why you try to do this, why you try to do that. Otherwise, even if I have a great culture, but execution is still very hard because they may not trust you. That's why with a great culture, with a great definition of a company value, our company value is care, and meaning we care about the community, customer, company, teammates, as well as ourselves. And also understand how to build a trust framework. I think that's pretty much, for us, to focus on, building a company where our employees, they like, enjoy working, here.
Eric, you know, you sound like it's so seamless. It's just, it's in your blood. It's part of your, it's the way you live and think, and probably for your whole life, right?
Absolutely, because when I was young, I did not understand the purpose of life. Until I understand the purpose of life is to pursue sustainable happiness. And a sustainable happiness, you know, comes from making others happy. I think after I realized that, you know, everything has changed. That applies to my personal life. That also philosophy also applies to our company's, you know, culture and execution, everything.
So that's exactly what Covey's point is. It's through caring relationships and caring actions and connecting to a bigger world, connecting to other people. And that's the mission and the vision that you have for Zoom, right?
Totally right. Yes, exactly. Yeah.
That's fascinating. And he talks about smart trust, right? So it's not just trusting anyone for any reason. It's being really authentic and smart in how you extend trust.
Absolutely. Like a hunter, you know, our relationship, right? Started many years ago, right? And, you know, I trust you, you trust me, and you are my great friend. You give me advice and sometimes I join your session as well. I think this is a great example, you know, how to build trust, how to help each other, and how to give each other advice, you know, make sure both of us can become a better leader.
Well, thank you for the compliment. But right back at you, you know, I always would say one other thing, love. You need to love what you do. Love your work, love your people. And it's a verb. It requires action, right?
You're so right. If you do not love your work, you know, quite often you try to understand how to balance the work and the life, right? It's so hard and there's no way to balance. But however, if you love your work and your life is part of the work, right? So, and that'll be easier. So,
perfect. I love it. We're right on the same page there, Eric. Hey, what's next for Zoom? What can we look for in the next 6 to 12 months in terms of new, interesting enhancements, features, and the platform growing?
Yeah, we are on a journey to transform our company from being a video conferencing killer app company to become a platform company. So meaning we would like embedded Zoom into other business workflow applications. At the same time, we would like to build more and more Zoom apps. Essentially, you know, today you look at you and I on a Zoom call, you know, quite often if we do not speak, meaning, you know, it's sort of useless, right? How to, you know, add more and more other contexts to the Zoom video conferencing. Like you and I on a Zoom call, we can send a document, right? Like a DocuSign Zoom apps, right? I think this is one example, right? How to, you know, leverage our Zoom SDK, build a healthcare application, build an online education application. That's also important too, right? So essentially it's how to leverage Zoom as a platform, you know, transform the way for us to work, learn, you know, live and play. That's our, you know, vision and the next, you know, several years.
Great stuff, Eric. You know, when you think about Zoomtopia, probably in 2022, you're probably going to be in person and hybrid, right?
Very likely hybrid. You know, over the past 2 years, you know, 100% virtual event. I think it will be hybrid next year.
How can we, HMG Strategy, myself, and our network of people that love you, how can we help you envision the future for Zoom and be more helpful?
I think first of all, before we finalize all those features, I think we would like to talk with, you know, our customers, partners, you know, very trustable advisors like you and your network. Make sure we truly understand all those features help our community, our customer now, right? And then we can tune our, you know, the roadmap and the feature set, right? Before we finalize. That's why, you know, this is kind of a, you know, how to solicit the feedback, you know, from your network. This is very important for us.
Hey, it's the largest independent. And if you learn anything in the pandemic, independence matters. It's the largest trusted independent network of tech leaders, CEOs, CTOs, CIOs, CISOs, search executives, and venture capitalists in our on the HMG platform, global platform. The global matters as well. Would you agree? It's a global world, right?
Totally. Your network is very powerful, right? Over the past several years, you know, you already gave us a lot of great advice and feedback. I'm so grateful to you and to your network. I really appreciate
awesome.
It.
Awesome. It's mutual feeling as well, Eric. You know, when you think of Zoomtopia, when is it? How can people get engaged? And I certainly want to attend. I'd love to be part of the agenda.
I think you know the our next year Zoomtopia very likely be in a held, I think, hybrid, and also September 2022. Probably 3 or 4 months before that, we are going to open up a registration page, and yeah, stay tuned.
Eric, thanks so much for coming on today's HMG Spotlight. We loved it. I love you. It's great. I can't wait to see you again in person.
Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it, my great friend. Thank you.
We hope you found this episode of HMG's Executive Leadership Spotlight beneficial. The HMG Global Network, a network of 400,000 technology leaders and a media platform that delivers more than 1 million impressions per week, is a valuable source of insight, continuous learning, and peer-to-peer research based on the insights and experiences of world-class, top-tier technology executives. Leverage the HMG network. Go to HMGstrategy.com to find out more.